Aye, there it is again.
What is it, Captain?
Oh, the rebuilding of the old temple over there. I hate it. Seen it over 40 times now, I think. The Queen must think gold grows on papyrus stalks. Does she really want to restore everything on the Nile? Even Amon knows she's causing trouble for poor folks with her taxes.
But the new temple is beautiful, is it not? I have heard her room is covered with magnificent reliefs.
Aye, reliefs depicting her sacred birth, presumably.
What else could the reliefs depict? Hatshepsut was fathered by the sun god and named Pharaoh in her cradle.
Aye, so she claims. I'd much rather have anyone on the throne but her. Her half-brother, Thutmose, when will he grow up? She has been ruling and using money like water, and we have to put up with this. Will Thutmose ever be Pharaoh?
So, you don't admire the queen, I presume?
May the queen live forever. May my tongue be clipped if it speaks another word against Hatshepsut.
Rest easy, Captain. You just stated your opinion. So, would you like to overthrow the queen?
I said no such thing.
A wise precaution. The queen's spies are everywhere.
No doubt.
There are reckless fools in Thebes who are organizing in secret to remove Hatshepsut from the throne.
I know nothing of them, honest.
Perhaps. But we must give them credit, Captain. They work hard for what Egypt really wants. Yet every time she erects a new temple, Count Semut the architect, her favorite, grows mysteriously richer. They say that the gods themselves will soon rise to strike her down, and Egypt with her. Should we permit? Excuse me if I may continue. Should we permit these crimes? They ask. Can we risk the gods' anger? Is this woman not a peril to all of Egypt?
You not make me speak treason. Hatshepsut is Pharaoh, so be it. Maybe Thutmose is not fit to rule. That is it. Only a weakling could be held down by a woman so long. Like a rabbit in a snare.
You are mistaken. Thutmose is no rabbit. He is a lion. And there is not a snare made that will hold down a lion forever.
Who are you? Who speaks treason now?
No one, Captain. We were just speaking of snares and rabbits. Nothing more.
Snares and rabbits. Excuse me, I must prepare the boat to dock.
Good day to you, Captain.
Mara, so there you are. The master shanties must be starched and pleated. Start working like the slave you are. Let's go.
I wish his body was stolen to the Nile and devoured by crocodiles.
Well, Zasha is very much alive, and his whip is even more livelier. So if you do not wish to be whipped, I suggest you start working.
Go away, Teta.
I will not go away until you get up and put that scroll away.
What is one scroll to Zasha? He is rich. Ugh, just to think about it. May all evil take Zasha and his kin. I mean, the dogs in the marketplace live a better life than we do.
See, I put it back. And by the way, is there anything to eat in this workplace?
Sure, go help yourself. Of course there's nothing to eat here. Someday I'll have gold. So much gold, I could have waterfowl every day. And buy Zasha a trip to the crocodiles.
Gold in your dreams, Mara.
Sometimes dreams are but prophecy. Farewell, Teta.
You were like a slippery frog, too much trouble.
Go away, Zasha, you barbarian.
What have you stolen today, Mara?
Bread, because you never feed us enough.
You and the whip shall become close today.
The pain of the whip is nothing compared to being in your presence.
Let her be.
Who are you?
I never gave you permission.
Shut up. I want to buy this slave of yours.
She is valuable. I refuse to sell her.
Name your price, or I'll simply take her.
In whose name?
The queen's name.
Listen, what is your name?
I am Mara.
I see you speak Babylonian.
I speak your well.
Listen, I bought you for a reason. If you shouldn't take this task, I will sell you immediately.
What if I decide to say yes?
Well, you'd be accepting death. But if you complete this task, I will set you free.
Well then, yes. I would rather die than be a slave.
So I thought. Here's what you are to do. Anani, a Canaanite princess, is going to the palace to marry Thutmose, a young pretender to the throne. You will accompany Anani in the palace for an indefinite amount of time. Listen to whatever the servants and Thutmose say. Keep your eyes and ears open. I need to know this information.
So I'm a spy?
Exactly. Use this to pay for your passage to Abydos. Find the Inn of the Lotus and tell them a man named Song Wen sent you. Obey my orders and I will set you free.
I understand.
And remember, Mara, you're still a slave.
I'll try to remember.
Hey, little girl. Heading to Abydos, are you? We are a cargo ship. We only carry sheep's wool. Who do you think you... What a heavy burden for someone of such small size. Why don't you let me take that for you? Here, you can sleep over there. We leave in 5 minutes.
Don't be afraid.
I fear no one. Who are you and why do you stare at me as I sleep?
I am a passenger on this boat, just as yourself. My name is Sheftu, and I was only staring at you because I'm surprised to see you here.
Why? Can I not be here as I please?
Surely you can. It's just... forgive me. Perhaps we may start over?
If you wish.
You see that statue over there? An ancient king built it long ago, right on the bank of a Nile. Isn't it beautiful?
Wow, yes it is.
Legend says that the king's ghost comes around at night and circles the statue, making sure it is not forgotten.
How strange and delightful. Are you a storyteller?
No, I'm just an apprentice to a scribe in Thebes.
That's an interesting trait to follow. I could have been a scribe to Zasha, but the man couldn't trust me with his words.
Zasha?
Oh, this man I once knew. A dumb one. He thought I had the evil eye.
How could evil come from someone so beautiful? Tell me, what is your name?
My name is Mara.
Mara? Truth of Ra. Who wouldn't trust someone with a name such as yours? What?
Excuse me. Could I have a word with you in my cabin?
Excuse me for a second.
I meant you to suspect.
Then I am right. Surely you'll need a captain, a ship you can rely on. I'd give up my life.
We all have to give up our lives. Money. Anything and everything we can to get Hatshepsut off the throne.
I see. I want to be one of them.
You are, and I thank you for your commitment.
But tell me, what shall I do?
What do we have here? Are your ears tired? Why don't you come inside? You could hear much better. It seems you have gotten yourself into an unpleasant situation. I warned you, and now I have no choice. Kill you, or use you. I prefer the second one. Now come, do exactly as I say.
What condition?
You serve me instead of your master.
You know who my master is?
Zasha, the dumb one. I saw you in the marketplace. I need someone like you, mysterious, witty, and smart. It will be challenging, but I'm afraid you have no choice.
You're right, I don't have a choice.
I'm glad you see that. Prince Thutmose needs a messenger for the rebellion. Someone who can infiltrate the kingdom without being noticed. Maybe sly and crafty as yourself.
Wait. Are you thinking about the Canaanite princess who is now docked in Abydos? Do you think she could be her...
As a ferocious barbarian? No way. Everything about her screams Egypt. It would be good, but...
I speak Babylonian. Won't the princess need an interpreter?
An interpreter!
No, they would have already thought about that.
We will change their plans. Besides, this one is far better off for us. Of course, we need somebody to turn those rags into riches.
I'll take care of that. I know an old sandal maker in Abydos. He would do this for a price.
Right. Men will do anything for money.
Is he trustworthy?
He doesn't have family or relatives, but he considers me a friend. And he also bears a grudge against Zasha.
Oh, he sounds trustful. Buy garments from him. Give him this.
Excuse me. The ship is about to dock. I must leave now.
Mara, it is crucial for you to deliver my message to Prince Thutmose swiftly and discreetly. Tell him this. The Warhawk is coming.
What does that mean?
It is none of your concern.
Don't you trust me?
I do not trust you farther than tomorrow. Now go.
A rebellion against the queen? Wait till my master hears that.
interpreters Sangwen sent me. Thank you.
Whenever you're ready, please get dressed so we may go see the princess.
Who are you?
Interpret Su,
Domina.
Interpret Quai Locutor at Sirikai!
Interroga eum num abemus et devas advenim amus. Num quam istinct abeamus, dum adveniamus totens ad sacerdotis laudare taraximus.
Serva patientia, Domina. Illo non regato tamen possum tibi respondere. Noli solicitari. Necessias omnia laudi ut regem spectet. Mox debas discedimus.
Yo.
Princess? The queen requests your presence now.
Vesina, regina te expecta.
Behold the majesty of the Black Land, enduring of kingship, ruler of Upper and Lower Egypt, maker Hatshepsut.
Lift your head, Rose of Canaan. You may approach, my majesty.
Tole caput ed ad eam ambula.
Mara, nesquioque dicam.
May the glorious Hatshepsut rule forever. The princess presents her respect to your highness.
Congratulations on your arrival. How was your journey?
Salve, commodite habes?
Bene es mihi.
Very pleasant, thank you for asking.
Look at her. Is she not all we expected? A perfect match for my half-brother. A barbarian. Interpreter! Inform the princess that she will be expected to receive summons from my brother very soon. Sheftu! Send word to Thutmose that he must receive the Syrian at once, and you, Lord Sheftu, arrange for the wedding to be as soon as possible. Look how stupid she is. Can you believe he will actually have to marry her? But he will obey me, as he always does.
Pharaoh's name is glorious. Everything will be as Pharaoh desires.
You are so trustworthy, Lord Sheftu. Interpreter! Take the princess to see my brother. I regret I will not be there for him to see his foul future bride.
So that is a barbarian? Exactly the bride I'd expect. Send this creature away. Who might you be?
Mara, the interpreter.
What need of that? I speak Babylonian, a mumbling language.
But even her most glorious majesty must have realized that his highness wouldn't dare to speak to the Syrian woman in her own language.
For once, she is right. But even with the interpreter, I have nothing to say to her. You tell her I have no intentions of marrying her now or ever.
Regulus te salutant. Son of Pharaoh, live forever. I crave pardon. I do not believe you want to hurt this poor princess.
You mean you forgot I know how to speak Babylonian?
Your Highness, I only meant to spare this poor maiden who is homesick and frightened. I pity her and didn't want to tell her journey was in vain, not in front of your servants. Please let me do it in private.
Leave us, everyone.
Codexion. Regulus sperat ne turbatasis.
Now perhaps you will tell me who you really are.
Quid dicit?
Vult scire, num cumorio tibi esse, si sori exiden.
Ita vero, dic ei mihi placuisse.
I am the princess's interpreter, but also to your command.
At last, I thought as much. Who sent you?
His name is...
Say no one's name. The very walls are spies. Describe him if you can.
Rogat nom bene dormiwiris.
Bene dormi.
He is tall, high, and well-favored with eyes of the night. He is one to beware, but has laziness in his movement. In a crowd, he is just like any other man, but different. And his smile is like a potion.
Ah, I recognize my artful one. Tell me, is he safe?
He is safe.
Transformar.
Rogat num fratres valiant.
Florescunt. Imo mara quam magnum tempus locutus est, ut parvam sententiam dixerit.
Linguae gypta loquacrio est tua, etiam regulus parvo dolere cerebri laborat.
Dolo cerebri? Doleo. Rogat eum num medicamentum papaverus gustavisset.
He who sent me is quite well.
Where did he find you?
We met on the Silver Beetle.
I wonder what axe he has found hold over your pretty little head. Proceed with your sweet little Babylonia. Then give me his message.
Quid dixit tentavit medicamentum?
Minime, numquam istuit audivarat, sed tu eam delectas.
Re vera? Credo, necesse ei feminum esse, quae eum custodat et mulciat. Dic ei medicamentum cum manibus paraturum esse. Quam pulcher est, nonne mara?
Come, give me the message.
The warhawk is coming.
He is coming.
Mara.
Laetissimus est propter concilium tuum, et rogat num papaveris in horeo habe?
Nonum eam silicitari, ancillae ad patria papaveris tulele, medicamentum et imitam.
I crave pardon, but I must say something to my princess, or else she'll grow suspicious.
What?
Will your highness allow her to make-
Yes, yes, whatever she wants. We must have gold. Tell him that he must go on a journey. Mara, my life is worth nothing if this does not reach him. Do you understand? This is the message. Journey to the River of Darkness, steal from the dead, take gold, and bring it forth to me in the night.
Steal from a pharaoh's tomb? That's the worst crime someone could ever commit in Egypt.
Yes. I know, but those are his orders. Now be gone.
Inani, dolor cerebri crescit. Nunc eamus!
Cum dolore laborat omne delecto?
Ceritissime, domina. In hortu ambulemus. It is very pleasant to walk in the cool of the evening.
Yes, but will there be many Egyptians?
In Egypt, my princess, you must suspect that there will be Egyptians. I saw a gardener, but it shouldn't be too crowded.
Well, if you're sure, let us go at once.
Mara, look, I do believe that woman is from Syria.
She may be. Come on now, let us move on.
No, I know she is. Let's go talk to her.
No, your highness, we must not stop here.
Why not? I would much rather sit and speak to someone from my homeland than visit any garden.
I think you're forgetting where we are and who you are. Do princesses talk to common people like her? In Egypt, that is not done.
Well, she seems respectable and...
She's beneath you. What would the son of Pharaoh say if you demeaned yourself?
I must learn to be Egyptian. Mara, I think that centurion is looking at you.
Well, he's not as handsome as he thinks he is. Isn't it beautiful? Now lift your head, Rose of Canaan. And don't mind any of the stairs. It's not every day that these lesser people get to see the future bride to the king.
Thank you for coming so swiftly.
Who is he? What does he say?
This is Lord Sheftu. He was wondering if you found our country beautiful.
It's very beautiful.
I wasn't expecting you to be a lord.
There are a lot of things you don't know about me. Tell me, did you have your audience with the prince yet?
My lord wishes to know if you enjoyed your audience with the king.
Yes, you're very kind.
Yes, and he has sent a message.
Don't say it now. I know him by the name of the Falcon. Meet me there this afternoon. Will you be able to get out of the castle undetected?
I have an idea.
But at the end, I am not known as Sheftu. I am known as Zasha.
I understand, and will do as you please. Lord Sheftu was wondering if you found the wine to your taste.
Yes, it's very good.
Princess, are you ill?
No, but if you'll excuse me, I think I'm going back to the pasta rest.
Who are you?
Put this cloak on over your face and follow me. In here and show respect to your master.
What have you learned?
Nothing of interest.
And why not?
It's no fault of mine. Not even the cleverest of spies could learn anything from an empty room. His Highness sent everyone out except for the princess and me.
If this continues to happen, you will be of no use to me.
Nay, it won't always be so. Please give me a little longer.
I'll give you one more chance, but make haste. Find the messenger or their meeting place.
Of course, Master.
It would be unfortunate for you if you should fail me again.
Last night, weren't you?
I don't know, Captain.
Yes, you were, and Dad and me. What's the matter?
It's nothing.
Then dry your tears. There, that's better.
Thank you, Captain. You're so kind.
I am no captain. I'm just a sentry who guards the gate the Pharaoh never uses.
They keep one of you in second sentry?
Yeah, they do. They say I am too young to do anything else.
Well, no doubt. They're jealous, Cap...
Reshed.
Reshed.
You live in the palace? I never saw you before yesterday. My, you're a pretty thing.
Oh, you're so kind. What's the point of being pretty if you have a sore heart?
What ails you, little one?
My brother in the city is near death, and I'm stuck behind these gates and not able to nurse him.
Poor little maid. Who prevents you from going?
I serve the Canaanite princess and must stand by her. If only I could get out while she's asleep.
I mean, we can bargain. What would you give me if I turned my back?
Give you? I have no gold.
I don't want any gold.
Wait, Captain, you are too bold.
What of our bargain?
I will bargain if you promise not to scare me again.
I have 3 evenings off every month. Will you please meet me?
Perhaps.
Go on ahead.
Thanks, Captain.
How was your task getting away from the palace? Was it difficult?
Where do I begin?
You're a clever one. Now tell me, what was Thutmose's message to me?
Is that a spirit or a person?
No, that's just Sahir. He lived for a while in the Darkland. He's friendly. Sahir, come say hello tomorrow.
Live forever, face of the lily.
So anyway, what was Thutmose's message to me?
Who's the shy? Thutmose's message was to go to the River of Darkness, steal gold from the dead so that Egypt may live. Oh, Sashai, please don't do it. Just this once. Tell him you failed. This is the worst crime to commit in Egypt. You could die.
It is not my decision. I must do what I can for our prince and future ruler.
But to steal from a pharaoh.
There's something you do not know. In his lifetime, Prince Thutmose was robbed by his daughter. Don't you think he would be happy for that debt to be repaid and just to be robbed one more time to get her off the throne?
What if you don't return?
I will return. No, I don't have time for love.
Beautiful.
It must be different from the sunsets in Canaan.
Yes, it's so much softer than Canaan. One does not feel so small. Mara, let's not talk about Canaan.
As you wish, my princess. Then, why did you leave the garden yesterday?
I had some business to take care of. So be it. I know that man didn't want to talk to me. He was looking for you.
How long have you known this?
Since the first day I met him in the Lotus Garden. I know other things too. I know that the king doesn't want me, and he never will. I feel there's trouble around here, and now I'm a part of it. Mara, what's wrong?
Princess, you show me what my handiwork has done.
What do you mean?
I'm the one who caused this. You know part of the story. Would you like to know the rest of it?
Yes, of course.
I'm nothing but a slave. Not even 4 weeks ago, I was delivering bread and ironing shenties for my cruel master, Zasha. Then a stranger came with a bag of gold and bought me. He had seen my cleverness and wanted me as a spy. He told me I was to be your interpreter. Then Sheftu came and said I was to be a messenger for the rebellion he was forming. I was then sent to the palace and started to play both sides. I sent them both information, but I found out that Sheftu's cause was the better one. We must rebel against the queen and send Thutmose to the throne. Now I'm stuck in this mess with no one to blame but myself.
So, it's a revolution?
Yes, and I'm caught in the middle of it. I could tell Nahere Sheftu's name and be rich for the rest of my life, but now it isn't as easy.
So, you are in love with Sheftu?
Yes, but it doesn't matter. Tomorrow he may be... He only wishes for the king.
Well, so do you.
I'm such a fool. There will always be a pharaoh, just like how there will always be a Nile. Why should a poor maid like me care who rules Egypt?
You have seen the king, and he seems good.
Yes, he is kind, a great man. By Amon, why do I care? Will Thutmose ever remember I served him?
I don't know that much about pharaohs, but I have met the king and the queen, and they're not alike in any way.
Yet he is sending Sheftu on his most dangerous journey that he may not ever return from. I told him it was pure foolishness.
And what did he say?
I do what I do for Egypt. What does that mean? The pharaoh is Egypt.
He didn't mean that, Mara.
What does he mean then?
He did it for you.
For me?
Yes, you and all the fishermen, the artisans, and the people you have talked about. They are Egypt. He did it so that they may live.
I must leave now, my princess. I must await his return.
Farewell, Mom.
Goodbye. I was not expecting you.
I come when I'm sent. Come.
Well?
Oh, great master, let the shadows crawl away from...
Don't speak pleasant with people unless they want you to.
I have succeeded in keeping all the attendants with the king. This will allow me to watch for the messenger you told me about.
So you've come away empty-handed once again. You're useless. I will find someone else who can produce results.
No, I think the prince is not sending his message by word, but by glyph. I saw glyphs on His Highness's vases. They seem less like decoration and more like a message.
A message?
Yes, but I don't know what it means.
Write it here. The end of the falcon.
No, you must be reading it wrong. It's an owl.
No, I know of this place.
You do?
Yes, I will send a spy there soon.
You must send a qualified spy who can successfully infiltrate the inn. Perhaps I can do it.
Amazing. The rebel's hideout has been under my nose this entire time. You may try, Mara. Go now and await when you are next called. So was he into the falcon this whole time? We'll find this leader and crush him with his puny rebellion.
Where's Sheftu? Has he come?
I'm sorry. We've been waiting here for hours, but he hasn't come.
Look! I see him over there!
Sheftu, where have you been? I was so worried. What happened?
Mara, I've missed you so much. Our torch went out. We were stuck in the dark, in the tomb. We couldn't see anything.
Sheftu, I'm glad you're okay. Did you bring the gold?
Yes, I brought the gold.
Come into the light. It's too dark. I can't see you.
Dark? You think this is dark? You know nothing of the dark.
Aye, but I still can't see you.
But I can see you clear as day. Why do you still have this?
Sheftu, I'm so sorry. I knew I should have given it to you, but the old sandal maker in the vitals wouldn't take it. Here you go.
No, it's okay. Keep it.
Okay, well, I believe it was a good luck charm. After all, it brought you back safely.
I'm afraid we have to go into the inn to tell the people where we hid the treasure.
Go into the tavern. Tell the others I will be with them shortly.
Sheftu, so glad that you've come.
Mara's a spy.
What? No, she wouldn't do that to us.
There's only one way to find out. Come into the other room with me.
Sashai!
Sashai, are you okay? I'm so glad you're here.
Yes, I'm okay. And I got the gold. Tomorrow, I will send it on a boat called the Friend of the Wind. Mara, go tell Prince Thutmose that I have the gold.
Please be safe. I'll see you soon.
Sheftu, why have we come?
If the boat is raided tonight, we'll know that Mara is a spy.
So, what do we do now?
We wait.
I don't think they're coming, sir.
Just wait.
We raid the boat in the name of the Queen.
That's all I needed to see.
Sheftu, what's the matter and why have you called me here?
The ship was raided, Mara.
What? But how?
We know you're a spy, working for Queen Hatshepsut.
Sheftu, I would never do that, even if I were a spy.
Don't lie to me. There was no gold on that ship. It was a setup just to see if you were a traitor, and we found out you were.
I may be a spy, but I am no traitor. I would never tell anyone of that ship.
Don't lie to me.
Sheftu, calm down.
Nikon, take her away. Somewhere I will never see her again.
Nikon, will I ever see him again?
No, probably not. It's way too dangerous for you to ever come back. Let's go to the boat.
Mara! You?
Reshed, let me in. I'm in haste.
What are you doing out? That's what I want to know. I haven't seen you for 4 nights running.
I went earlier with the Canaanite princess at another gate. I would have wanted to come here, but she wouldn't let me.
Very likely. More likely, you found another simpleton to dry your tears when you crack a smile at him. Who is it?
It isn't as it seems. Now let me go. My brother is dying, and I need to help
him. You never had a brother. I don't know who you met up there, but I will stake my sword he's no sick kinsman. I've caught onto your game, you little witch.
It's not like that. I swear by the gods. Reshed, your captain.
Where? Mara!
Master, protect me. The rebels suspect me.
So they suspect you? How unkind of them to repay your friendship with cruel distrust.
Friendship? Didn't you send me there to find out their secrets?
You never told me the secrets you promised me. I sent a spy on you. Funnily enough, you already know him.
Live forever, face of the lily.
Est, you son of 40 devils!
Prepare the rail of the tavern.
Mara, but... what's wrong?
Everything's tumbled about my ears, princess. All's over, wrecked, smashed. Sheftu tried to kill me tonight. He couldn't do it, but my master intends to and will. Also, he'll hunt out Sheftu and kill his party. I need to get out.
Is there nothing we can do?
Even if I get out of this room, I still need to get past the palace gates. I'm trapped like a fish in a net.
Wait, I may have a way for you to get out. Remember the Syrian woman that I've been seeing? She has family outside the gate and usually goes to them at night. What if she brought an apprentice with her?
Oh, praise! Do you think she would do that for me?
She'll do it for me. Come, let's find you some Syrian clothes. You are leaving late tonight. Who's that with you?
My apprentice.
Move along. Good night.
Doing here? They'll kill you the moment you walk in.
Quick, you must warn the others. They're going to raid the tavern.
And why should I trust you? A moment ago, you were tricking me.
I have no other reason to be here. Please, I beg of you. They need to get out of the tavern and into the ferry. This is their only chance.
Very well. Go find somewhere to hide.
Have reason for celebration. We have seized people from the rebellion.
You have brought me one person. Are you to say that she is leading the rebellion?
She might not be the leader of the rebellion, but she can name the leader, the one they call Sashai. Do you not recognize her? She is Anani's interpreter and one of our own spies.
Who is this Zasha?
I do not know him.
Your Majesty, perhaps she has forgotten. Let us refresh your memory. Libyan?
Who is this Zasha?
I told you, I know him not.
Slave, I advise you to speak while you can. Libyan, double your strokes. Who is he?
Call off your ape. She will kill her, and we will be no wiser than we were before. Listen, Ralph. I will spare you all further punishment from your crime, if you will just answer the question. More than that, I will give you 50 gold deben and a silver chain. Think of it. All you have to do is answer the question, and you can walk through that door, a free maid, with gold in your pocket.
I do not know the leader.
By Amman, still silent, these rebels are madmen. Jatar, come forth again.
Up on your knees.
Good evening, Radiant One. Word travels fast about the capturing of rebels. But tell me, where are all the criminals? Surely Lord Nahari's soldiers captured more than just one slave girl.
A poor catch indeed.
Guilty or innocent, it seems you have had an ill manner of questioning her. She looks half dead.
Should she defy the Pharaoh and go unpunished?
Nay, but let me tempt her with a small reward.
We have tried that already. We have offered her gold and freedom. She has scorned them.
Scorned? Perhaps she knows nothing.
Or perhaps she knows much, Sashai.
Did you just say Sashai?
I did. The man who stands before you is none other than the leader of the rebellion.
Who is this madman? Majesty, he lies!
I can prove it. The leader, Sashai, wears an amulet on his wrist that I cannot see now. It is a golden snake with two red eyes.
The incorruptible Sheftu, a traitor!
Well, comrade, we best tell him everything. A pity, too, after all our precautions.
We? Do you tell me that Count Senma too?
Majesty, it is a lie. He is trying to drag me down with him.
Come now. Let us die with our heads held high.
Curse you, you'll die like a rat here and now. Loyal Sheftu, friend and traitor. You shall die at sunrise.
And my secrets with me.
Secrets?
The names of all of those who will overthrow you, and your plans as well.
But what good are plans without a leader?
My death is nothing but a stone thrown into the Nile. Do the waters stop for a stone?
Let us approach this in a different manner. Why go to your death when you can serve me in Count Senmet's place, have all of her land, her money, tax-free? Surely there is something you desire.
Aye, Majesty, there is.
This is your treasure?
Yes, the greatest treasure in all of Egypt. A maid whose loyalty cannot be bought. Whatever bargain we make must include her.
Then we shall make no bargain. Soldiers! Take them and send them into the next world!
Do not speak, my love! It will not last long!
Praise your mind.
The warhawk has come.
At last, dear friend, the battle is won. Little interpreter, you have saved Egypt and me this night. Never again shall you have to cover your shoulders. I declare your scars to be medals of honor. Count Sheftu, I advance your status. You shall be my right hand for as long as I rule Egypt. But now, go and find the finest physician in Thebes to treat this mage wound.
Thank you, my friend. My pharaoh.
Sheftu, it's all over.
No, it is just the beginning. Many things are beginning.
Where are we going? To find a physician?
The doctor will come to us, and he will tell his grandchildren of this great privilege.
Can't you believe it? You're a count now, and I'm a free maid.
A free maid? About to be a countess?
A countess? Sheftu, I only request two things.
As you wish.
One, for my princess to be sent back home to Canaan.
Of course.
And I want to buy a slave.
A slave?
Yeah, one of the named Teta of my former master.
We will have many slaves.
But I want to set her free.
Of course. It is a small matter to free a slave. Have we not just freed a king?
Mara, so there you are. The master sent he's much, much,
go away, Teta.
I will not go away until you get somewhere.
To the camera.
Right.
Oh, okay. I'm not supposed to
Wait, can you wait till I'm
ready? Wait till he's ready.
Should I, like, do it?
How strange and delightful. Are you a storyteller? Thanks to you, I'm
no, a former storyteller.
Are you a storyteller?
Okay, right. How could evil come from someone so beautiful as yourself?
Aww.
Oh, I didn't ask what your name is. Now I have no choice. Kill you or use you. I prefer the second one. Now come, do exactly as I say.
Whoa, wait, thank you.
Thank you. Oh my gosh!
Yo.
Send this creature away. Who might you be?
Hi, hola.
Come.
Transfer Mara.
More desperation.
Transfer Mara!
Stop. No, no. Never.
This is Sparta.
The Warhawk is coming.
No.
He is.
Now lift your head, Rosa Kanan. Higher. Don't mind any of the stairs.
Whoa, you can walk backwards.
I'm supposed to be in love with that person over there.
No!
Get in on the hug. Okay. Go. Come on.
I'm your conscience. You can hear everything I'm saying right now, right?
Sheftu, you're okay. Wait first. And then Sheftu, I'm glad you're okay.
You have to.
That's all I need to see!
Come on!
I may be a spy, but I am not a traitor, so...
Girl, you better stop sassing me right now!
Sheftu, calm down.
The conk.
Mara!
Can you not laugh?
Pair the veil, tavern.
It was
dude, that hurt! They have seized a member of the celebration.
Of the rebellion.
She is Anani's interpreter and one of our own spies.
One more time, and then...
Sorry! When the camera comes towards me, I have to do it. Okay.
I called it. You were gonna hit me.
Don't fall down until I, like, kill you. Do not speak, my love!
At last, dear friend, the battle is won.
Hello.
I'm Tebow.